Get ready to match the stars, Richard Deacon, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Dallas, Arlene Tilton, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raver.
Hello, John.
Thank you, friends.
You're okay, and you're okay to join us, too. Well, I greet you one and all, and hope that you're all ready to have a go at it. I hope the celebrities up here and you in the studio audience and you at home will join me in welcoming this newcomer.
We know how disappointed you are about her looks and everything.
Yes.
Look out, Charlene.
Well,
this is how it starts.
You're a little too old for me. But I welcome you anyway.
Thank you, Gene.
It's nice to have you with us, Charlene Tilton.
She told me if you did that, she was going to leave.
Wasn't Lolita a good movie, Brad?
There's nothing fancy, because I don't want to muss my lipstick. Yes.
I just think I'm too old for this business. And you're right.
Over here we have Connie Knuckles and Marilyn Fraser. Okay. Both of you know you'll play two games. And we'll see how it turns out. I welcome both of you. We'd like to find out a little bit about each of you and get acquainted. Marilyn, let's begin with you.
Well, I was born and raised in El Segundo, California.
Yep.
And I live in Whittier with my two children and my husband. And they keep me very busy. But when I get time, I play tennis with my husband. And I do cartooning.
You do? Do you sell that?
No.
Would you like to sell it?
Yes.
Okay, I'll give you a nickel. Welcome and good luck, Marilyn.
Thank you.
So, I can't believe that anyone is named Cotty Knuckles.
Well, it's true.
Tell me about that. You're Cotty Knuckles.
That's right. My real name is Claude Knuckles.
Claude Knuckles.
Oh, well, that's different.
He's changing it for professional
Cotty
reasons.
Out of Claude.
Well, my entire name is Claude Carlisle Knuckles III, and so my father and grandfather had Claude and Carlisle taken care of, so they gave me a nickname.
Cotty, yes.
Yeah.
Well, you certainly couldn't go through life calling yourself Claude Carlisle Knuckles III, now could you? And where are you from?
I'm originally from Albany, New York.
Really?
Yeah.
Good town?
Yeah.
Where do you live now?
I live in Culver City now.
Uh-huh.
I'm about halfway through my apprenticeship as a bricklayer.
As a bricklayer?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good for you.
Thank you.
I'm proud of people who work with their hands and have manual dexterity and skills like that.
A lot of them end up with clogged knuckles, though.
That's right.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Would you like to come and fix my wall?
I'd love to.
He'll fix everything that needs fixing over there. All right. Let's begin. Good luck to both of you. Marilyn, you can have A or B.
B, please.
B for her. B says, Kathy said, that guy I went out with lives in a really sleazy apartment.
How sleazy is it?
You're fired. Instead of etchings, he invited me up to see the blanks on his wall.
What does he do?
Got that? Very good. No, I think that's good, Charlene. Kathy said that guy I went out with lives in a really sleazy apartment. Instead of etchings, he invited me up to see the blanks on his wall.
All I can think of is graffiti.
Graffiti?
Yeah.
Okay.
What you say?
Graffiti's not a bad answer.
Oh, no, it's a wonderful answer.
Excellent.
It's a heck of a lot better than mine.
What's yours?
Cockroaches.
Cockroaches.
Oh,
they like cockroaches better than graffiti.
Well, they've been to my apartment.
I see. What do you got?
Well, I thought he was into something artistic. I said the cracks.
The cracks on a wall? Okay.
Cracks on
wait,
the
don't
wall.
Nobody move. Don't. Shh.
No, that's what? A friend of mine.
I'm gonna kill a fly.
It's a fly, Betty. It figures.
Could you people do it somewhere else instead of at my little place?
If you weren't stuffing your face all the time, the flies wouldn't be attracted to you.
They'd be attracted to him, trust me.
Oh.
See that. I hope it is.
I'm sorry, sweetheart. If you're from El Segundo, chances are you never had a New York apartment like Richard,
Brett.
Helen.
And I Roaches.
Roaches. Well, that seems to be the answer, the roaches. Okay, Charlene, what did you have?
I like graffiti better, but I said cockroaches.
Cockroaches.
Yes.
Okay. And you, sir, what did you say?
I said that if you had been a guest on my show and I had kissed Charlene, I would have then invited you to have a little kiss, too.
Oh, really? Why? Well, you don't do any kissing on your show.
We do very often.
Oh, you do?
Yes, pucker up.
I heard about those game show hosts. Now, listen.
Are you ready?
How come you wear a three-piece suit on your show and you come up here
now,
with a two-piece suit and no necktie?
The last time that I was your guest, you put me down for the same reason. I wore a jacket this time and a handkerchief.
Yeah.
And I think our audience will agree I look cute today.
Yes, he's cute. Okay, now would you show us your answer?
You will pucker up. Yes. I had an answer that has brought applause wherever it has been seen. Cockroaches.
Okay. Well, we have five of those so far, Marilyn. What do you got there, Miss Betty, honey?
You game show hosts have a gay old time.
Cracks on the wall. Not all of us. Okay, Cotty. They call you Cotty, eh? Not Cod.
Cotty, that's right.
Okay. Ben said, my wife is half Italian and half Chinese. So when she cooks, she puts fortunes in the blank.
You've got it too, sweetheart.
Everybody finished. Very good. All right, Cotty. Ben said my wife is half Italian and half Chinese. So when she cooks, she puts fortunes in the...
Meatballs.
Meatballs. Meatballs not a bad answer. I guess you could... roll them up and then roll a meatball around the little piece of paper that said you are about to meet an enchanting woman.
And then you microwave it.
Yes.
But I said lasagna.
Lasagna. You see, you know, like elbow macaroni and lasagna and all of those things that would contain something. What do you got?
He said lasagna because he's a gourmet cook, you know.
Yes.
He cooks the best monkey bread west of the Mississippi. You could die for it. We are supposed to match him. He's supposed to match us.
Right.
Gotcha. Big ball.
Meatball. Okay.
Lolita was a good movie.
Meatball. That's true. Cotty. What do you got, Charlene?
I've got ravioli.
Ravioli. Ravioli, you know what they are?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Little square things.
Yeah.
You put something in it, stuff something in it. That would seem to me to be the definitive answer for a question like this. What do you got there?
Well, what was the definitive answer?
Ravioli.
I have pasta.
Pasta.
Now, wait a minute.
Pasta is a... all-encompassing omnibus answer.
I want this audience to know that being here is not just a pleasure. This is an inconvenience. Be careful about... I will not tolerate hissing and bullying.
Oh, okay. But you're okay for kissing. All right, Betty.
See, I have the same thing that Charlene. Not as much of it, but I have the same thing. I have a neatness thing, and ravioli just seems tidy and where you can...
Perfect. Yeah. Okay, now it's 2-0 in round one, and you stand by, both of you, for round two. First this for you. All right, here we go to round two. Cotty, since you're ahead, we'll ask you to go first.
B, please.
B. All right. The chief of police said to the new rookie, I'm afraid we've run out of funds to buy you a bulletproof vest. The best we could do was buy you a bulletproof blank. How tall are you? How tall are you?
5 feet.
You're 5 feet.
You're acting just like James Mason.
Okay, guys. The chief of police said to the new rookie, I'm afraid we've run out of funds to buy you a bulletproof vest. The best we could do is buy you a bulletproof...
handkerchief.
Handkerchief.
It's small.
Hear the mob out there?
No.
They not only don't like your answer, they're going to beat you up later.
They're a hateful, unloyal group.
Yep, they are. Okay, Richard Deacon.
What did he say?
Handkerchief.
Well, I think it's the same thing. Hanky?
Hanky. There's one for him.
Interesting.
Guy gives a rotten answer and scores. Okay.
I know a lot of people who are
able to. How often that happens.
That's the story of life.
Yeah. Now, speaking of scoring, let's see here.
I haven't done anything.
I haven't touched her.
Sad.
Yes.
What? So sad to sit this close to something like that and see it. Sad. I pray to God when I'm his age, I don't act like that.
Yes,
I said bulletproof tie.
Tie. A good answer. Tie is a good answer, right?
Is that a good answer?
That is a good answer.
I think it's a splendid answer.
Splendid. Yeah. Well, because it she would cover something, so yeah. You know, a certain part that would become bulletproof.
Well, and it tied in with vest, and you and I had just discussed my tie. It had a lot of things going on.
Yes, of course.
Except the match.
What were you saying, Betty, about a big...
Big bow tie would cover it, but
big bow tie, not in your case.
He had a handkerchief, but he blew it, so he had a tie.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay. All right. Now, here's the way it is, Marilyn. 3-4. Ready? Bernie is the world's greatest car salesman. Yeah. He'd even take your blank in trade. World's greatest car salesman.
You always nod so approvingly of everything she
wants. Well, this is her first time on, and I want to give her confidence and make sure that she feels secure and at home and loved.
Sure.
I want to feel all of those things, too.
Yes.
Well, then go somewhere else.
You know what?
What?
With my lovable image, America will loathe her after that.
That's right. Yeah. Okay, Marilyn, here it is. Remember, you need 3-4. Bernie is the world's greatest car salesman. He'd even take your blank in trade.
Your wife?
Your wife. Good. Seems to me wife would be the definitive answer in this case. Take my wife. Okay,
please.
I'll take your wife. How much? $1.98. All right, you got it now.
You got it.
Okay.
Wait. I was going along more along the line. She went, oh, what a nice man.
Marilyn Lauren.
Is it alive? Yes. Oh, my. Tricycle.
Tricycle.
Well, that's like wheels, like an automobile. Like...
Yeah.
Oh, now don't turn on me.
Right.
Everything to you, and now you're turning on me.
Oh, I can't stand. You have a hanky?
No, you don't even have a punch.
Three the last round. White.
Okay. Score is now 3-2. Bernie, the world's greatest car salesman, he'd even take your wife in trade. What do you say to that?
I was going to say wife, but I thought that mother was better, so I said mother.
Mother. Okay.
He might want the wife.
Hmm?
He really might like the wife. He might be getting a bargain if he takes the wife instead of...
Right. You could write your senior dissertation on this.
Yes. Isn't this sad? Look at it.
Pitiful. It's just pitiful.
All right, Bob.
I was going to say mother.
Yeah. Keep your hands above the table at all times.
Come down.
What?
What?
What? Get up there!
Well, she was going down. Yes. No?
You know, if this keeps up, Peter Marshall will be the only one in business.
Wait just a darn minute. Whatever became of old Alan Ludden?
Yeah, whatever.
Dead. I think that old Alan Ludden.
You're perfectly. Where were we?
I don't know. I'm waiting for a response.
Whatever we were doing, Alan would fit in perfectly.
He'd even take a blank and trade.
Oh, yes. I was going to say mother.
Yeah.
And then I thought I'd get along better with my mother, so I said, why?
Score is now tied, 3-3. It'll end in a tie or a win if you match Marilyn.
We may have to have a meeting.
Okay.
Because if his wife was an awfully good skate, we've got a match.
Okay, I skate. Okay, so it ends in a tie, 3-3, and we'll tell you about tiebreakers right after we tell you about this. Deacon never looked lovelier, did he?
I never had hair.
All right, now to go to the tiebreaker, we must turn off these lights first. And now we must push this button, reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Marilyn, you can have A or B.
B.
B is what she wants, and B is what she gets. Did you hear that prudish Prudence got fired from her job at the nightclub? Oh, you'd like to know what happened? Well, I'm glad you asked. I'm going to tell you what happened. When the owner told her to go topless, she walked out on stage without her blank. Ready?
Wait a wait.
Now we're going to start without you, Brett.
Go, baby.
Did you hear that prudish Prudence got fired from her job at the nightclub? When the owner told her to go topless, she walked out on stage without her...
hair?
Without her hair. I don't know how you do that, but it sounds...
I do.
Oh, you do, yeah. Yes, for you it's
wanna
easy.
Want to see a career build on that?
Yeah.
I think this is a match. I don't want any problems.
Wig. Wig. Oh, yeah. One for Marilyn. Make it two for Marilyn.
No, I couldn't. I said without her glasses.
Without her glasses?
Yes.
That would anger the boss?
Now, listen, that's two.
Yeah. I'm waiting for three.
All right, here we go.
You know, it must be sad to, like Richard, to be, you know, have no hair. It must be a sad
yeah,
thing.
Really, yes. Okay. All right, Charlene. Speaking of hair, go, show and tell.
Hat.
Okay.
Oh, sure, Bob? No matter what she said, you go hooray.
Yeah. Show us yours.
You will doubtlessly, Eugene, will doubtlessly want to cheer wildly for Wig.
Yes, Miss Betty?
Now, do you want to see the self-same answer get a different reaction? Hat.
Okay.
Oh,
all right, Patty, here we go. Fat Phyllis's husband said,
right.
I just brought home a bathroom scale that's almost human. When Fat Phyllis stepped on it, it blinked. Fat Phyllis's husband said, I just brought home a bathroom scale that's almost human. When Fat Phyllis stepped on it, it said, it blinked. When Fat Phyllis stepped on it, it blinked. Fat Phyllis's husband said, I just brought home a bathroom scale that's almost human. When Fat Phyllis stepped on it, it blinked.
It groaned.
Okay. Yeah. All right, Richard, groaned is the answer.
It hit her.
That's nice. What do you got?
Now, this is like a groan. It's the same thing as a groan, except it is feminine as opposed to masculine. Scream.
Okay, there's one.
Yeah. You got it.
Said, holy cow.
Holy cow! That's a human scale. Charlene, what's yours?
Screamed ouch.
Screamed ouch. On the map, score is now 3-2. Bob?
It squealed.
Score is tied 3-3. What do we got?
Your basic scream.
Scream! Connie Nichols wins the game. Okay. Why don't you come on down here? We'll say goodbye to Marilyn Fraser. You'll be back later to play game number two. Okay, right there in the blue dome. While we're spinning her off, we're going to spin a message for America. You were all wonderful.
Thank you, sweetheart.
What's that, a union meeting over there?
Yes, well, yes, it will.
They were explaining the rules of the game to me.
Oh, I see.
Well, don't you know,
9 times.
Charlene has been going with Johnny Olsen for a year and a half, and everyone knows it but you and Bob Barker.
Oh, it's sorry,
and Johnny's
John.
Wife, Penny.
Didn't mean to encroach on your territory.
That
join us next
time
for the Match Game. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are a 10-inch silver-plated champagne cooler from Taylor Rental Centers. Taylor rents practically everything. When you want it, rent and save at Taylor. And a tray and Super Slaw, a great new flavor discovery for coleslaw made with real yogurt. Super Slaw in your grocer's produce section. An HR rug and room deodorizer, the right way to freshen your rug and room. Available at your supermarket's HR carpet care center. And Salad Crunchies, an exciting blend of color, flavor, and texture. Just sprinkle it over any salad. Salad Crunchies and Coil Magic. It cuts through buildup on air conditioner coils. Apply directly or use this garden sprayer. Coil Magic saves energy as it cleans. And Goof Off, the latex paint remover that really cleans up when you mess up. It's the finishing touch to a perfect paint job. Goof Off. And a Servant and Be Fresh makes every flush a deodorizing shower to automatically freshen and help fight bowl ring buildup in 3 original scents plus new powder fresh. Put a shower in your bowl. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast.